Federal investigators are trying to figure out what led up to this, a bridge suddenly collapsing during the morning commute, five cars and this bus plunging with it.
Our engineering team will look for signs of stress in the materials that comprise the bridge, signs of fracture, signs of deterioration. But again, I do want to stress right now, those are just general. We have no factual information on this collapse.
First responders racing to the scene, rappelling down this ravine to form a human chain, pulling people from the partially crushed bus. The bus driver frantically calling for help.
I was more concerned with getting the people off the bus because I wasn't sure, you know, where the bus was sitting, if it was going to slide backwards.
I can't believe this happened.
10 people suffering minor injuries, but no one was killed. The Pittsburgh fire chief says the outcome could have been much worse.
A half hour later, the bridge would have been full with vehicles, with commuters going back and forth.
According to the Pennsylvania Department of Transportation, 14,500 vehicles travel over the bridge daily. The overall condition of the 52-year-old structure was listed as poor during its last inspection in September.
We saw today when the bridge is in disrepair, it literally can threaten lives.
The collapse happening against the backdrop of President Joe Biden's visit to the city to highlight his $1.2 trillion bipartisan infrastructure law. The president seeing the damage and destruction up close and promising swift changes.
Across the country, there are 45,000 bridges in poor condition. It's just simply unacceptable.
Morgan Norwood, ABC News, Los Angeles.